Yeah, an excellent performance by Bobby Hamilton, and right now he's kind of sweating it out to see whether he retains that pole, because Ned, as we are back live now, we've got a lot of fast drivers to watch qualify in the next 90 minutes. Sterling Marlin will be next out. Jeff Gordon is coming out before too long. Bobby Labonte, so on and so forth. Dale Earnhardt also yet to qualify. Benny Parsons is with the guy that just came off the racetrack moments ago, Darrell Waltrip.
Yo, sandbagger, you.
Ben, I tell you, I don't know how I did that.
Now quit stammering.
I don't know how I did that. The guys, you know.
He's stammering. He's sandbag.
They said we'll be happy with a 53 flat. So you can imagine how happy we are with a 52.8. That ought to get us in the top 20, and that really makes our job easier. We can prepare now for the race. So just concentrate on race setup and get out and draft some tomorrow, and it really puts you ahead of the game when you can make the top 20 the first day.
Drafting going to be important here?
Oh, yeah, drafting. And, of course, as hot as it is, Ben, you got to work on grip. You got to get traction, and we got to work on getting as much grip as we can on old tires.
Fight off the corner, right?
That's it.
Congratulations. Good run, DW.
Thanks. I love it.
And while we were watching Bobby Hamilton's run, Ned, as we now watch Sterling Marlin, he was into turn one pretty quick there at the start-finish line. He was a mile an hour quicker than Bobby Hamilton, but slower at the end of the straightaway. Jeremy Mayfield turned in a 171.012, third fastest.
Great
so far.
Lap for Jeremy Mayfield in the RCA Ford, the Cale Yarborough entry. As we can see, Marlin picked it up coming off of turn two, got the same speed as Bobby Hamilton. A little bit slower going into turn three than was Bobby, so I don't think Sterling has a pole run going here, but he's going to have himself a good starting position for Saturday's Brickyard 400.
172.002 was the fastest practice lap that Sterling Marlin has been able to achieve so far yesterday and today. There's the checkered flag, and Sterling Marlin completes his qualifying run and checks in for his second event here at the Indianapolis Motor Speedway. It's 171.553, and that puts him second quick. He's on the outside of the front row right now.
Good lap. We knew he had a good one going there when we looked at those speeds, the corner speeds. He was a little bit off in turns two and three, but he picked it right back up.
So Sterling Marlin has now gone on to the back stretch in his cool down lap. Let's check in with Jerry Punch, who's with a driver who has yet to go out. Doc?
Upside down at Daytona, the 125. Did you realize this car had run this fast at Talladega? I said, not really. It's the same race car. We just put a new body on it. I cut it off at Daytona, and they just put it back on at the shop. So they did a great job. The guys in the motor room did a great job. You know, we're real proud of the Interstate Battery Chevrolet. We're not the fastest right now, but we don't really care what anybody else runs. We've definitely improved off from Daytona, and we needed to do that. So we're pretty tickled. Maybe later they'll give me some ice cream.
Come on, guys. Give that poor driver some ice cream. I mean, he's hot out here. Oh, yeah, they can, yeah, then take it back. That's the way they do them, Jerry.
That's a family affair. That's Jimmy Maycard, Ned's son-in-law. There's the crew chief. Oh, Bobby's going to take a whole handful. There you go, Bobby.
One of the things I'd like to tell the folks here, and it's good, the weather seems to be identical to when we were here approximately a week ago. And this fellow here, 49.85.
Ooh.
Now, if he can duplicate that this trip, which I think he'll get close, he's going to have a shot for the fall. I know the fall's running real good, but I was watching Ned's boy running, and he was getting towed a little bit, so it's going to be interesting to see if he can hold off the force to put this thing on the pole.
This boy here is Kodak Chevrolet driver Sterling Marlin, two-time winner of the Daytona 500 and a winner here at Talladega last July. He's a three-time pole sitter at Talladega Super Speedway, although he has never won the pole for the spring event, the Listen Select 500. Time to beat 191.077. First lap for Sterling Marlin, third quickest, 50.281, 190.450 miles per hour. And Bill Weber's caught up with Jody McKinney.
And he's actually the next car to go in line. He's just being pushed up to the line right now. He sits in the Burger King Chevrolet, just got a good luck kiss from his wife, Andrew. You're in about the middle of the pack right now.
Yes, you know, the Burger King Chevrolet's been running pretty decent, pretty hard in practice because there's so many cars out there, but hey, it's been a tough year for the Burger King crew, but we're still pumped up, and we're trying hard.
Okay, he's very optimistic, wants to put up the window net. These guys work extremely hard. They were one of the cars this morning who had a little trouble getting through inspection, had to shave off the nose, and then they were okay. Sterling Marlin on the track.
Nemechek had to trim that whopper a little bit this morning, but we've got a new pole. Second lap for Sterling Marlin, 49.973. First driver under the 50-second mark, 49.973, 191.
Marlin up next. The defending winner of the Daytona 500, his only career win, and he was the 1992 pole winner here at the 500. 193.494 was the speed he was looking for to knock Dale Jarrett from the pole position.
And I wish we could get a microphone down for you folks to listen to this four car. This, there, you hear him as he goes by?
Yeah.
That's a different sound than you're used to hearing with a stock car. It sounds a little like an Indy car.
Or even an IMSA car. It's much, much different than any other ones. Hey, look at this. He's equaling Dale at the end of corner number two.
And this is just his first lap.
This thing just sounds fast, doesn't it?
It does sound fast. Sounds like it's got a turbocharger or something.
Yeah.
On.
High-pitched sound. And he's close to Dale Jarrett's trap speeds. The total on lap number one was 46.737, 192.567.
Now, that's faster than Dale Jarrett's first lap, isn't it, Ned?
Yes, it is, about 300ths of a second.
Uh-huh. And same speed down in turn one for Sterling Marlin.
Let's see what he gets at the end of corner number two. Oh, he's faster than Jarrett.
Now, here's the key. Can he go in turn three at 198 miles an hour?
Nope.
No, he can't. 196, so he's 2 miles per hour slower. Might be enough to cost him the pole position. Critical. Turn four.
Got the car real low in turn.
Uh-oh.
Oh, he's a mile an hour faster in the trap off of turn four. The lap total, 46.548. It's 193.349. Not quite good enough, but at that point, he was second fastest. So Dale Jarrett continues to hang on the pole, but look who's waiting to go out in the GM Goodrich Monte Carlo Chevrolet. It's Dale Earnhardt. We'll have his run when we come back. Well, here were the top qualifiers with just a few left to go. Dale Jarrett hanging on the pole in a Ford, then Chevys of Marlin, Presley, and Terry Labonte. We talked about the strange noise from that Sterling Marlin car. Jerry Punch caught up with Tony Glover.
Tony Glover, that car sounds a little bit unusual. Sounds like an Indy car almost. What's the engine deal? The headers or what? What is it?
Well, I don't know. Some have been aggravating us about a new driver. They're calling him Nigel Marlin now. But it's just something that the guys in the engine room come up with a little different combination in the engine, and seems like it's working pretty well.
It just sounds so different than anything else we've heard today. We used to hear the old 180-degree headers. Is it somewhat of a variation from that?
Well, not really. It's more like 140-degree headers. But to be honest with you, I think it's a little slower, but Larry and Runt likes the way it sounds, so I guess we're going to run it.